Jones. Good morning to all our donors, sponsors who are present, of course, members of the media, and Jordi's team and family. My name is Shirley Christian. I will be chairing this very brief Carlton, we say, right?
Yes.
Ceremony this morning. And of course, this is the official handing over ceremony for Jolly's National Wellness 5K run, which was a very, very well executed event, which I did not get a chance to take part in, but I will make my excuses for that later. But this is the official handing over ceremony. We would like to begin with a word of prayer. So I'd like to invite Mr. Dover to lead us in prayer as we begin this ceremony this morning. May everyone please stand.
Thank you. Good morning. Can I pray, please? Heavenly Father, we just like to, you know, thank you for this day. Thank you for health, Father God. Thank you for strength, and thank you for allowing us to be here, Father God. You know, Father God, we come to you humble and just giving thanks. And Father, we just want to continue praying that you bless them, you keep guiding them, you know, keep blessing the leadership, Father God, with this vision that they have. And you know, you said in your word, Father God, that you know our bodies are your temple, Father God, and we should take care of it. And Father, they are doing an exemplary job by encouraging us, Lord God, to take care of our health, Father God. And this is a very fervent part of our bodies, Father. So, in order for us to stay healthy, Lord God, they are doing a job which you have ordained. So, Father, we give you thanks and praise for that. Father, we want to continue to ask you to continue to bless the sponsors, continue to be there for them, and that they continue to take this seriously, Father God. We know health is an issue all around, Lord God, but one step at a time. We want to thank you for each and every sponsor here and for each and every member of the Jolly's Pharmacy for this great initiative 5K run. And we pray blessings, Lord God, that it may continue in the years and years to come. So, Father, as we go forward this day, this donation that we are going to make, Father God, I pray that it continues to bless the foundations that it will go to and that they will continue to use it, Lord God, to honor and glorify your name, Father God, through outreach and helping and assisting persons. So, Father God, once again, bless these proceedings. Take full control and guide us in your mighty name.
Amen. Thank you, Mr. Dover. I'd now like to invite Mr. Carlton Lando to deliver the opening remarks. And, of course, Carlton Lando, the PRO at Jolly's Pharmacy and the voice
behind all these great initiatives. Carlton, I welcome you to the podium to deliver your opening remarks.
Thank you so much, Trudy Christian. And you would know that Trudy Christian is no stranger to Jolly's. She's one of our honorary staff and one of my co-hosts of Health Vibes, those who listen to the Health Vibes every Wednesday morning. I believe that she has brought in really fresh love, nice synergy to Health Vibes. My name is Carlton Lando. I am head of sales, public relations, and public health at Jolly's Pharmacy. I am a registered pharmacist by profession, and I am maybe the brain behind many of these activities and initiations that you would have seen, initiatives that you would have seen Jolly's have sort of developed within the past 10 years. JNC, which is one of the departments that we have at Jolly's, it means Jolly's National Clinic. We, our whole aim is to encourage all populace from birth on to death in optimizing our health and wellness. I've always said the greatest resource that any one of us possesses is our health. Is our health. And so we have to do everything in our power to make it the number one priority in our life journey. And what we do, we, as you would see, we do a lot of work in nutrition and fitness. So that's why we have the Jolly's Gym.
We do a corporate screening. I see some of our partners are here. We've done screening for the Dominican Football Association, for National Bank of Dominica, for Central Corporate Credit Union, for the Wasco, and many of these companies. We go in and we actually present, and we do preventative health screening to these companies, because sometimes you're at work and you do not get the opportunity to even go out there to see a doctor or to go to the health center. And what we've done is that we've seen so many people that we've intercepted diseases that were already afflicting them, or we have, or at least we could have said, listen, you're on the borderline to having X, Y, Z. And what we've done is even added more services to our GNC. So right now you can get your cholesterol done, you can get your HbA1c test done, you can get your body mass, you can get your body mass, you can get your bone density test done. All of this under one umbrella, Jolly's National Clinic. But we are talking about the 5K run. And a couple of years ago, I recognized that Barbados had this big national run, and St. Lucia has it, Jamaica has it. And I'm saying, but we don't have any such thing like that in Dominica. And hence, the idea came up of actually having the Jolly's National 5K run. It is our third, this year we need our third episode, and it was the first one that wasn't rained out. But I will tell you what, even in the two previous runs that we had, people ran under the rain. But this year, we had blazing hot sun, and it was really, really, really cool. We sort of made some changes and decided to sort of, rather than just making it one course, kind of broaden and make it multiple courses. And so this year we ran for lupus, we ran for kidney failure, and we ran for strokes. And I must say we coordinated it with colors, and that made the run even more interesting and creative. It was an excellent initiative. It was one that was even better based on your participation, your sponsorship, and even your own way of amplifying the activity, because we really recognize that more and more every year this activity is going to get bigger and bigger and bigger, and that's what we want. We want the next one, which is going to be in September, we want to see at least 5,000 people decked out and really showing that they care. Next year, well, in September, we will be doing diabetes and sickle cell anemia, all right? Because we do know there are many people who are afflicted with sickle cell anemia. It is one that's very, very painful, very debilitating, and they need support. There is an association here, and we will be lending our support to sickle cell anemia and diabetes. Again, diabetes is another very serious chronic non-communicable disease that is really, really causing a lot of havoc within Dominica. Many people are losing their legs, their toes, their sights, losing their sensation in their extremities where they cannot feel. So can you imagine your mother touches fire and doesn't feel any sensation and doesn't even know that they have gotten burnt? And so that is why we are trying to really kind of not just sensitizing, because most of us know about these diseases, at least we know some of the symptoms and complications, but at least how aware are we in terms of what can we do to prevent it? Some of it we will still get it, but at least how can we delay the early onset of these diseases? I remember, and I'll share that with you shortly, a very short shot. In 2020, I was trying to get life insurance policy. I did all my medicals, and then I found out that I was pre-diabetic, and my cholesterol level was borderline high. The pre-diabetic thing freaked me out. Honestly, being a huge advocate for health and wellness, and I'm saying, but I'm taking care of myself, you know, I know that diabetes is in my family, but yet still, I was very, very shocked to know that I was pre-diabetic based on my HbA1c. And then I did myself an audit and asked myself, what is my lifestyle like? And I recognized that my lifestyle was a bit sedimentary. Though I was never a big person, but I recognized I was not engaging in any physical activity. I started at the Pottersville Savannah, running around that savannah every afternoon, running across that savannah every afternoon. And I did so for about 5 weeks. And then afterwards, I recognized I could sort a little more. And I think most people see me running almost every afternoon. I do at least a 5K run every afternoon. Now I can do a 5K run in 32 minutes. Right? And guess what? My HbA1c came back normal. So we can modify, we can make lifestyle changes, sometimes with our diet, sometimes, as we said, with physical activity, with meditation. A lot of us stress out a lot. You know, every little thing gets us anxious, and guess what? That in itself predisposes us to mental health issues, predisposes us to hypertension, predisposes us, and subsequently, cardiomegaly, enlargement of our hearts. And so we have to take every advice that is possible to ensure that we can remain healthy people, we can see our children graduate, we can ensure that we live in the house that we've built, because guess what? When we die, our wives or husband will bring somebody else, and they will have no work to do but just relax on the queen size bed. Right? And you might be rolling in your grave depending on who is now in your space. So let's not imagine that happened prematurely. It sounds funny, but it's true. It happens. You know, life continues. But we are excited. Johnny's Pharmacy is excited. And I want to acknowledge the managing director who is out of state at the moment. Usually, without any hesitation, when I come to him with an advice or an activity that I want to execute, he usually says, once you believe it's going to do well, go ahead. We will put the money towards it. And so our activities have always done well, and we want to really thank you, the Dominican public, as well, for endorsing and trusting the Jolly's brand. Because with the Jolly's brand, you have credibility, you have knowledge, you have talent, you have skill, you have passion, and guess what? You have loyalty. Because based on what we do, you recognize we've never been a selfish company.
True.
We've always given back.
True.
One way or the other.
Yeah.
And we're happy to do that. By the end of May, our next major activity will be geared towards women. And so we are having a health, a wellness, reproductive and sexual clinic for women only. And that's where women will get the opportunity to have their pap smears done, their breast examination done in a safe space with doctors and credible, competent senior nurses. A lot of women are saying, you know, I prefer the old-time nurses, the way they used to care for me, the way they used to talk to me. And so we've heard your call. We are bringing them in. Those that have retired, we'll be using Dr. Jolly's office, Borsate Clinic. We're asking you to register your name, call Jolly's Pharmacy, register your name. We will be charging only $40, and that covers everything. Only $40, and we do everything for you. If there is, so let's say you have an infection, the doctor is right there to write a prescription for you, and you can get your medication. So we want people to, again, access these, because guess what? A lump that is detected early can save you your life, lots of money. A pap smear that is done properly and is can detect HPV, human papilloma virus, which causes cervical cancer, if it is intercepted early, your life can be spared. We will be having one for the men somewhere in September, but we are having the one for the women at the last Wednesday and Thursday in May. And that will be for 2 days. So we're not doing it for 1 day, we're doing it for 2 days. And we will be doing it from 9 to 4 on both days. So Jolly's company continues to lead the way in healthcare. And again, we want you to reciprocate. You support the Jolly's brand, and we support you as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Lando. And you know, just from those remarks, you see why you need to, on a Wednesday morning, listen to Jolly's Health Vibes. Okay. We always make health have lots of vibes. Lots of
especially
vibes.
Especially when you're talking about sex.
So just from how Mr. Lando spoke, you know, discussing health is not a boring thing, and public health and preserving health and being educated about health is in no way, shape, or form boring or something that you shouldn't be engaged in. So this is just, you know, a sample of what you get on a Wednesday morning for free on Q95 Radio from 10:15 a.m. Jolly's Health Vibe. So just plugging in the show right here. So the 5K run, which from what Carlton has said, all of us, even, you know, someone like me who did not get a chance to do it, in the future, need to take part, because the causes that are going to be represented later on, diabetes, sickle cell anemia, of course, very important. But this 5K run, the foundations, the associations that will be benefiting from this great endeavor are very worthwhile ones. Of course, the Lupus Foundation, and yesterday was World Lupus Day, May 10th, and of course the awareness that was brought forth yesterday was great, and we need to continue in that line. So the Lupus Foundation will be one of the benefactors from this 5K run. The color that represents lupus awareness is purple, and the people who ran for lupus wore purple. The Ray Astor Foundation, which is bringing great awareness to stroke, which is another very prominent health issue locally. Back when I was in the Ministry of Health for a brief time, was the top cause of death, mortality here in Dominica. So the Ray Astor Foundation, the color is red, and so people who ran for stroke wore red. And the Dominica Dialysis Association, so another cause was kidney failure, and the Dominica Dialysis Association is also represented here today, and the color is orange, right?
Yes.
Green. Green.
The official color.
Official color. Orange. Oh, yes. I was like, okay, I'm losing my colors. So orange is the color I was born
under.
Yes. Right. All right, so we invite the representatives from these different foundations and associations who will be benefiting from the money that was raised at the 5K run. We invite them to give some brief remarks. How can you, the sponsors?
Let me acknowledge the sponsors.
Okay.
Very
so Carlton will first acknowledge the sponsors, and then we will have the remarks from the foundations and association that I just highlighted. So Carlton,
yes.
I invite you back to the podium.
This could not have been possible without the Dominican public. So even before I acknowledge the corporate sponsors, I want to really acknowledge the little boy, the little girl, the infirm person who may not have walked up the Jolly steps because their knees are bad, but they said, listen, I've heard about this, I can't come, but here is my $25. Put it towards diabetes, put it towards lupus, put it towards stroke. I said diabetes. But put it to words, one of these for me. I had a customer who was shopping, and she said, "Mr. Rando, man, you're such a blessed man." She took off, opened her bag, took a checkbook, and wrote a check for $70. And she said, "Put that towards one of those courses." So we had activities like that. I had somebody donated $500, and anonymously, she said, "Do not call my name at all." My husband would not have liked that because we like to do things quietly. But here is $500. Even if her company had sponsored, she wanted to personally donate $500 from her own money. And so we had those. And many Dominicans really came out in large numbers. One of the things that touched me even more is at the venue, the starting point of the run at the Master Kinfield Government School, people who may not have had the opportunity to come into Jolly's at any of the branches to make their contribution, they walked with it. And nobody left with that $25. They looked for me and they gave me that money in my hand. And that was very, we actually picked up about $800 on site on that day. So it showed the passion and the commitment that the Dominican people have towards these causes. However, I really want to acknowledge our corporate friends and sponsors who really, in this very difficult economic time, many companies are still struggling post and still with the pandemic. Many companies lost money and could not even have given some of us, you know, a little promotion or a little increase in salary, but they felt touched by the initiative and they felt even more empathetic to the many people who oftentimes have to walk around asking and sometimes even begging for help because that individual was just diagnosed with end-stage kidney failure, needs to go to St. Lucia to put in a fistula, and doesn't have that $4,000, and has to walk in the hot sun, sometimes weak, just to get that money accrued. All right? Or that person who was very productive just suddenly fell to the ground and sustained a massive stroke and is totally immobile and cannot do anything. And that breadwinner now have to either source somebody to take care of them or they themselves have to give up their work to take care of that loved one. Or that individual who was diagnosed with lupus and is told that their kidneys are now failing because of the complications of lupus. And these are the realities that every one of these medical conditions plagues on a day-to-day basis. So it's not just the victim or the patient, but as well families they suffer. And so we are really happy that these corporate sponsors have come on board to make the monies available. We had American Fresh, which is one of our premier companies that we are the distributors of all of the detergents. They sponsored the big hampers that the winners got the day of the run. Seven Seas, of course, for the many samples that were given. Halibut Wash, the Dominica Football Association, the president, Mr. Glenn Litty, and I was so happy when he called and he said to me, "You know, I have been so busy, but we want to give a contribution. And we want to split that contribution, making sure each of these NGOs receive some amounts." The Dominica, the National Bank of Dominica, for again assisting and making a financial contribution. The WASCO, NAGICO, you know, when we call, and I call Miss Stedman my friend, she said, "Of course, Carlton, write us down, put our name down, win this." Twampito, Josephine Gabriel, they are always two with us. All of the water that you will have gotten and all of the runs, they have always been given by Josephine Gabriel and Company Limited. They have never charged us for not one bottle of water. And so Mrs. Gabriel and Jenny and all of the team there, we really want to say thank you. The Central Cooperative Credit Union, Michael. Thank you so much. And I see the marketing manager is there and Senator as well. We want to thank you so much. Sagico, from the inception, Sagico has stood with us from the very first drug which we did for diabetes a couple of years ago. Mrs. Roll and her team, and she rallies. And one of the things about Sagico is that beside their donation, yes, she, Mrs. Roll, have to make sure every staff makes a donation personally. And so we really want to say thank you to them. To Lewis Welding, that's a young business. The owner himself walked up our steps and said, Mr. Lando, this is the amount of money I can give you, but I want to be part of this, a welding company. And we really want to thank them for air conditioning and your welding. We really want to thank and recognize Mr. Lewis and his wife and his staff for really doing so. Digicel, of course, the bigger, better network, they say. We want to thank them so much. That's what I said. They say it's the bigger, better network. And so we want to thank them for, again, making, you know, their monies available to discuss it. QFM Radio. When I called Mr. Gregoire, he did not hesitate. I have his personal number. I guess is that they say, No people. So I called Mr. Gregoire in Toronto, Canada, and I said, Mr. Gregoire, you know, it's your partner here, Carlton, you know, doing that. Mr. Gregoire said, well, Carlton, you know, I just never tell you no, you know, because you're always up to something and put us down. And, you know, Kimberly sent that check so fast. I almost thought it was lightning and a stroke, you know. Civic Vibes, and that is another NGO, Mr. Loftus Dura. They made a very good donation too, and we want to thank them. Beautiful, B-U-T-F-U-L. I can never pronounce it. It's my wife's business, but I just can never pronounce it. And, you know, I believe it. I gave her the name, you know. For whatever reason, truly, what should it be? So for your pedicures, manicures, massages, waxing, I know a lot of the ladies will be going there for Mother's Day, for the wax. I don't know how we'll be doing that, but all power to all. The Dominica Police Force, you know, they have always stood with us and have given us security every time we've done this. The Republic Bank Limited. And one of these agencies are going to be very happy with the Republic Bank because they gave one of these NGOs all of their donations. And the Republic Bank, Davis, Miss John, Mrs. Savrin, again, it was your second time collaborating with us, and I suspect you all will make it a staple. We really want to thank you, the Republic Bank Limited. Mams Supermarket in Massac. We heard the hi-fi. They've always donated their hi-fi to us, even a truck if we need it. And so I want to thank Mrs. Jolly and the Jollies. They are also Jollies too. Mams Massac for really, again, always coming through for us. The Goodwill Improvement Committee for the use of the grounds, and they did not charge us any money at all. We really want to thank them so much for, again, donating these the ground to us. And of course, Jolly's Pharmacy. Jolly's Pharmacy. It takes a lot of money to do these activities. Believe it or not. It may look simple. You have to pay Red Cross. You have to pay the DJ. You don't do it for free. You have to get the refreshments, buy them. You have to, like today, we have to pay for the hall, right? It wasn't for free. You pay for snacks for you and everything else. So it takes a lot to put on those activities.
Yes.
The advertising, the our graphics guy. You know, I want to thank the Jordan's marketing team as well for their good work. But two, I want to thank, I used to have an assistant who I called my permanent secretary, Mr. Edgar John Baptist. He worked with me for about 4 years, and he was the most efficient assistant you could have. But now he has moved on to a bigger position, and I have Ms. Jeremiah, who is as competent as he is. And Ms. Jeremiah, I want to thank you for the hard work that you've done. You know? And I think you are an amazing assistant, and I want to thank you for it. So, again, to all of the sponsors, thank you, thank you, thank you.
From our foundations or NGOs who will be receiving the donations this morning. So we will start off with the Lucas Foundation, who is representing for Lucas Glory. Okay. So Glory Thomas will, the president of the Lucas Foundation, will deliver remarks on behalf of the Lucas Foundation. We had a fabulous time yesterday at Woodrow's Day. The Lucas Foundation want to thank Jolly Pharmacies and all the sponsors of the Jolly's Pharmacies National Wellness Foundation. Also, the other NGOs, we want to thank you too. Because without you, we would not have gotten the strength to form our organization and help our organization. We partner from you all, we follow you all throughout what you all do, and we improve ourselves on it, spreading our awareness. You don't know how we are, because it has been a battle for us with financial sponsors for our members, and even in raising awareness for us. This donation will go a very, very, very long way in raising awareness, because numbers have been rising, and most persons don't know or cannot tell if somebody or the signs, the symptoms and everything of lupus and what they are going through. And we do go through a lot. It's not only the stroke that put us down on we are out of work. We have some members that just can't work. Yesterday, a short event we had at the first conference, we had a member that spent the whole night at the hospital just coming out to do any legal activity, strenuous on her body. So we want to thank you once again, and this will go a very, very long way. Thank you very much.
With the different health conditions, with their medical expenses, but also to increase awareness. Sometimes awareness is what leads people to diagnoses that they would not otherwise have gotten if awareness was not being made. So very, it puts things into perspective here today. And we
would now like to invite the representative from the Rick Astor Foundation. Who will be speaking, Gael? Okay, so Gael will be representing the Rick Astor Foundation and delivering some remarks on their behalf.
The Ray Astor Foundation was founded in memory of Raymond Astafan, a promising medical student who aspired to be a neurologist. Our foundation focuses on stroke care, rehabilitation services, training, advocacy, and education for persons in the community affected by stroke by providing hope through compassion, transparency, and generosity. Donors like you help to keep our nonprofit foundation running by expanding our reach to the community. To the community we serve, sorry. We know you have a lot of choices when it comes to donating, and we are so grateful that you chose to donate to our cause. Again, we thank you.
Okay, and the last NGO who will be benefiting from the funds raised from the 5K run is the Dominica Dialysis Association. Dialysis, from my knowledge, a very expensive process, and those afflicted have to undergo so much expense as it relates to managing kidney failure, kidney disease. So the representative, who will be representing? Mr. Bless. I invite the representative from the Dominica Dialysis Association, Mr. Bless, to deliver some remarks.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I would like to say thank you very much to Mr. Carlton Randall and Jolly's Pharmacy for helping us and supporting us, because dialysis is a very, like the lady said, dialysis is a very, very expensive procedure. It's a very expensive illness. It's not the end of the world, but it can really take you out of this world. It can put you back a lot. So this donation will go a very, very long way to help a lot of people, because right now, like the lady from the Lupus Foundation was saying, our numbers are even beginning to climb. We start to find even more people with kidney failure and kidney issues. So this donation will go a very long way into helping a lot of people. And our goal, our ultimate goal, is to try to get people to not reach the stage where you have to end up on dialysis. So thank you again, Mr. Rando, and thank you again to Jolly's Pharmacy for helping us.
Representatives have spoken, and now I believe this is the moment that we have been waiting for, that we came here for the presentation of what was raised from the 5K run for these different NGOs. So we'll be presenting Mr. Emonews Jeremiah. Okay. So Mr. Lando will hand over and do the presentation. So stand ready to receive.
You know, Lauren, you've inspired me to continue to really push for these local NGOs that promotes and highlights medical causes. I could feel your emotion, and I could really feel too the struggles that all of you experience, and sometimes too, it comes with discrimination, and the sad thing is particularly the discrimination comes from people that's supposed to know better and do better. None of us know what the role is. So let us just think on that for a few seconds. I'm going to call on my assistant, but before that, we actually raised 14,198 Eastern Caribbean dollars. The largest share of that money went to the Dominican Dialysis Association. And if you really look at it, the two other diseases can lead to them.
Yes.
Yeah.
You see?
We have members who.
That's it. That's it. And so somebody could have had a stroke, right, as a major complication, but they have. They are diabetic or they're hypertensive, and these are the two major diseases that can actually cause you to end up having end-stage kidney failure along with lupus as well. So we're going to call firstly Mr. Blairs from the Dominican Dialysis Association to receive a check. Well, there are a few checks that were written directly to you.
Yeah.
All right. Well, everything amounted to $6,650. That will go to the Dominican Dialysis Association, or foundation, rather.
Association.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Then we have the Lupus Foundation of Dominica. The Lupus Foundation is receiving $3,873. That figure again, $3,873 Eastern Caribbean dollars. They're receiving $3,675. That is $3,675 Eastern Caribbean dollars. We have full confidence that the funds will be used prudently, efficiently, smartly, and with good accountability as well. You know, so your treasurers, you know, will ensure that these monies, though we hope to, would have loved to give each $10,000 at least. But we want to really thank, you know, all of the donors that have given to make this contribution a success and this activity a success. We wish every one of you well. All of these NGOs, we wish you well. We will continue to pledge our technical support. Currently, we have already begun giving all the members of the Dominican Dialysis Association a 10% discount on all of the prescription medications. Maybe we may do the same for the Lupus Foundation at some point. Once they send their request with the official, because you have to be a member of the association. You know, we'll be able to maybe lend a similar support to them. But we try our best. We try our best. And again, that's what we always say to Dominica. When you support the Jolly's brand, you support Dominica.
Amen.
Okay? Mm-hmm.
before we wrap up, to support the Jollies brand and to support health and health advocacy here in North America. So, we are now wrapping up. We are at the end. The money has been given. The smiles have been smiled, and the pictures have been taken. And we will now be wrapping up with a vote of thanks. Forgot something? Okay. All right, we have an added feature. So the Dominica Dialysis Association has been conducting a raffle, and they want to do the draw live right now. So the winner of that raffle can be announced right here live. We have all our media present. So I will call back Mr. Les. We'll be doing the dip. You'll be doing it?
Okay. No, you can do it.
You can do it.
Really?
Yes, I would prefer if we have somebody not in your association doing
it. I'm not known to be a lucky person. I'm not so known, so whoever took part in the raffle, if you don't win, just know I made my disclaimer. I tend to be.
So we have free prizes. So
okay.
We can ask each of you to take a chance.
To take
a
dip. Okay. Yes. What are the free prizes?
Pardon?
What are the free prizes?
Well, there are free prizes in the raffle draw. One of the prizes is a day pass to the Jungle Bay Resort. That's the third and the second prize, a day pass each. And the first prize is a fridge.
Oh.
First prize, fridge, and second and third prize, day pass to Jungle Bay. So I am looking forward. Food prize?
Yes, we started with food prize.
Okay, so Jungle Bay. People who have taken part, cross your fingers and your toes. Okay. I have dipped Robertson, I believe, Riviere of Bath Estates.
Okay.
Robertson.
Yeah. That is something different.
Yes. Robertson or Riviere of Bath Estate, but the phone number is there, yes, so they will contact you. You're going to Jungle Bay.
Good price.
So taking for second prize to Jungle Bay. I have Judy Berry. From Alaska. Judy Berry.
I guess somebody will pick up on
this.
And Carlton will dip for the first prize, the fridge. Carlton.
That's my fridge now.
It's a deep fridge.
Oh wow, deep fridge. I was positive I didn't know about that. I need one for my house. Okay.
As a pharmacist, Carlton is supposed to be able to read the name on this paper, and he handed it to me. Anyway, I think it says R. Wilson, I believe, of Castle Comfort.
Oh.
You have won the grand prize, the first prize of the deep fridge. So congratulations to all the winners of the raffle of the Dominica Dialysis Association.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Yes. So I now invite, as I said, we're wrapping up, I now invite Miss Leona Jeremiah, who Carlton already explained is his very competent assistant, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of Jollies Pharmacy Limited management and staff, I would like to express our sincerest gratitude to all our sponsors, partners, donors, everyone who supported the National Wellness 5K Run. Without your generous contributions and your support, we could not have made this event a success. I want to extend a special thank you to our sponsors, Republic Bank, Dominica Football Association, Mom's Supermarket, Josephine Gabriel and Company Limited, the National Bank of Dominica, Najico Insurance, Digicel, Q95 FM Radio, Central Cooperative Credit Union, Sagicor Insurance, Dominica Broadcasting Service, Doasco, Dr. Damien Dublin, Bon Santé Medical Clinic, University of the West Indies, Lewis Welding and AC Services, Dominica Police Force, Civic Vibes, Goodwill Improvement Committee, as well as our signature brands, Haliburage, Seven Seas, and America Fresh. Thank you. We would also like to thank all the individuals who donated, who worked for the cause, and who have spread awareness about the event. Your support and enthusiasm has truly touched us and inspired us to keep working towards the goal of promoting wellness and healthy living in our communities. I must acknowledge the tremendous efforts put forth by the three NGOs today, the Lupus Foundation, the Dominica Dialysis Association, and the ReASTA Foundation, in their continued work to aid persons suffering from these conditions. Your dedication and commitment Your dedication and commitment to improving the lives of those in need is truly inspiring to us, and we are honored to have been able to partner with you for this 5K run. Last but not least, I would like to highlight our company, Jolly's Pharmacy, for organizing the event, and it is with our unwavering support to health, overall patient therapy, and public health concerns, we are able to do these things, such as the 5K run. Our commitment to community, passion for wellness, has always been a driving force behind the success of our events, and we are grateful for your continued leadership and support as NGOs, as sponsored partners, as well as the general community. Finally, I would like to thank the media for capturing the event and sharing it with the wider public today. Your coverage has helped us to spread awareness about public health issues, and we are grateful. Once again, thank you to all our sponsors, partners, donors, and participants for making the Jolly's National Wellness 5K Run a huge success. Your contributions have been truly great, and we look forward to your continued support in our future endeavors. As we reflect on the event, we are reminded that the power of community and the importance of coming together can make a difference impacting these causes. As Mahatma Gandhi once said, the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. Let us continue to work together to promote wellness and healthy living in our communities, and to support those in need. Once again, thank you for your support, and let us look forward to even greater success in the future.